Hi, it's the Lipstick Gal. Thank you so much for watching today. I wanted to show you the 10 eyeshadow palettes I have been excited to play with and I have been loving for fall. I'm just gonna start with the one that I am wearing today, and it's this. This is the Mountain Trail palette from Sydney Grace. Look at these. Look at these beautiful, murky, green shades with pops of gold. They are so gorgeous. I mean, I had so much fun playing today. I really feel the standout parts of this eyeshadow palette are the pressed pigments in here. Look how gorgeous they are, especially this one right here. Now, the mattes are equally impressive. And I feel like when you're looking at this, you can get such a gorgeous, beautiful eye look. And this is not the cool sorts of greens. These are a little bit warmer. There's more gold in them. They have more of that slightly olive or earthy lean to them. And that's the sort of green I enjoy. I like more of this kind of warmer green and less of a cool like mint or something that leans a little more turquoise or a little bit more like bright leaf green. This is the sort of stuff that I like to wear. And this really gives me that slightly warm and cozy feel. It's just gorgeous and the formula is fantastic. Definitely one of the ones I was just waiting to get into. Now, you don't have to wear this only in the fall. I've worn this like all year long, but I really especially reach for this come fall and winter. This next palette is also from Sydney Grace. It's the Be Mine palette. This is one that I picked up in, I think January this year is when they released it, but look at these shades in here. You have, you know, kind of like some plummy pinks. You have some warm neutrals. You have some shades that get decidedly darker and have a little bit of grunginess to them. But I really feel like the metallics in here are absolutely stunning. You can build a variety of looks here. The mattes are also really good. When I first got this palette, I spent a lot of time right here in the center row using kind of like a pink and plummy sort of look. I would pull in this shade right here and maybe this brown. And then since then, I have started just kind of mixing and matching across the palette. I love the look that I get when I use these kind of warmer tones on the top. I love bringing in some of these deeper shades along the bottom that really bring out a little bit of grunginess and depth. The other thing is, this is the light version of this palette. If you have a richer skin tone than I do, this also comes in a deep version, which is what I love about Sydney Grace. So many of their more neutral leaning palettes come in a light and a deep version. So you'll find one that has transition shades that are perfect for your skin tone, but the quality cannot be beat. I love these so, so much. All of the palettes that are like this are magnetic, meaning you could pull every one of these pans out using a magnet and rearrange them, create your own eyeshadow palette using like a variety of different ones. I really like the ease of like rearranging things in there. I usually just leave them where they are, but there are times that I'll pull like single shades out of here and build my own palette. I really love Sydney Grace's formula. It's my most loved, most used, I think most purchased like brand of eyeshadow. All right, if you are looking for something that is a warm, toasty, delicious, cozy vibe, this. And it's $3. This is one of my favorite drugstore eyeshadows. This is the Bite Size from Elf and Pumpkin Pie. And these shades are so, so good. I mean, look at these. You get two really nice mattes, two gorgeous metallics, for $3. This is the one that I use the most, and out of the three that I have, I think that I appreciate this one the most because it's a warm neutral and it's a little bit more every day, but it's not terribly boring. On my fair skin, these kind of warm, pumpkin-y tones can be really fun and bright and bold, and I love it for that reason. But if you haven't tried these bite-sized eyeshadows, I really don't think you can go wrong. Most of them are really good. You just have to find a color story that you like. I do love small eyeshadow palettes, so when I was thinking about shades that I wanted to use this fall, I thought of both of these pedophores. This one here is the Chocolat from Viseart. It's very much in line with the Pumpkin Pie, I feel. Yes, we've got very similar shades in here. I feel like there's a richer brown here and a lighter, brighter metallic here. So you get a little darker here, you go a little lighter here, but I feel like they have a lot of similar ideas. My favorite thing about this is I feel like the formula is really beautiful. I really do love the mattes in here. The mattes are really good. The metallics are really pretty. I am making a mess. My hands are so grimy. I look like I've been like scrubbing out my oven. My hands are so gross, but I really feel like these are beautiful. Viseart is one of those brands that I slowly have been collecting a little here, a little there, basically based on my love for the formula. I knew the formula was good, but it wasn't until I tried these pedophores in the fall of 2020 that I fell head over heels. And the one that always brings me back to that place of absolute adoration is this one. This one is Praline. And I love that this is like my perfect everyday neutrals. Every day, I could wear this all day long. They're so good. And the metallics, look at these. The shine is insane. They're so beautiful. These are $25 pop. I feel like for the quality that you're getting, the packaging is super cute and adorable. I like that it's magnetic. I like that it has this little ribbon pull. I like that there isn't a mirror in here. A lot of times I'd be like, but where's the mirror? But the truth is, these are so small. If you're using a mirror that small, you're really getting a good look at your face. I like to just leave this open on the countertop in front of me, grab my mirror and a brush, and do my eyeshadow. I don't miss the mirror in these smaller packages from Viseart, but I really feel like it's a great way to try the brand at an affordable price without paying through the nose. And if you can get them while they're on sale, they're totally worth it. Snap them up. If some of these shadows were a little too warm and toasty for you, let me show you my favorite neutral eyeshadows of the moment. One of them is this. This is the Divine Skies eyeshadow from M Cosmetics. This is in the shade Rodan. There is another one of these in a deeper shade. It's more suited towards deeper skin tones, but this is the one that I love. It has beautiful everyday shades in there. And when I wear this, sometimes I'll pick one or two shades. Sometimes I'll wear all six. But the ease of these are just insane. This is one of my favorites to wear as a one shadow look. I've used this shade here as highlight, this kind of milk chocolate sort of matte shade. Sometimes it's the only shade I use, and I just put it a little bit in the crease in the outer corner just to give a little bit of depth without looking like I'm wearing too much makeup. I really love this. I especially love the packaging. I like that every single one of them comes in the exact same packaging, but the color is different. So I don't have to flip it over and look at the backside and go, okay, which one are you? I like that I know based on the coloring of the package. I like that we're getting 1.5 grams per pan here. I know that the little triangles make them a little bit different, but you're getting a really good amount of product. And I feel like this is the sort of product that gives me a variety of looks. I can use in a lot of different ways, but it's kind of like my everyday palette. I like the formula. It wears well with and without an eyeshadow primer. It lasts all day. It blends itself. I mean, I really like this formula, and I think it's fantastic. And I am glad that I have like 3 of them, and if they come out with more shades, I'm likely to pick more of these up because I really like this. But this one in Rodan is the one that, since I got it, I kind of default to and reach for the most. Now, if you want a few more options and you love nudes, might I suggest this? This is the Side by Side nude palette from Nabla. All right. So this is for the person who wants cool neutrals, who wants warm neutrals, who wants mattes, who wants sparkles, who wants everything. It also has a really nice sized mirror in here, which I like, but I also like that I can just fold it over and like hold it like this and, you know, use my own mirror and go to town. But this is one of those palettes. I didn't really think that I was gonna like it. I'm like, I have so many neutrals. I have so many, you know, palettes that are similar to this. There's something about this that keeps me coming back to it. I don't know exactly what it is. And it could be that everything I'm looking for is in the same place. And it is a little bit larger than most palettes. I like a smaller size palette, you know, stuff that's a little bit on the tinier side. 9 pans is kind of like the max, but here with these 16 shades, I really feel like I have everything I need. And you can see by my fingers that I have been in here big time. This one down here in Love Ritual is one of my favorites. It's kind of a cool shade. I like this one in Ray of Light a lot. And oh, this one right here. So look at how pretty these are. These have a really gorgeous sparkle quality to them. The mattes are nice. They blend well. They're easy to apply. It's just a great formula. This is the only Nabla palette that I have. It kind of makes me think I need more, but I tend to not go for the Poison Garden has really bright, vibrant colors in it. There's a lot of other palettes that Nabla makes where the shades are a little bit outside of my comfort zone. And when I saw this one, I had to have it because this is the sort of everyday eye makeup that I love to wear. This is the sort of thing that I rely on heavily for a work day. When I've got a bold look going on and I want something soft, but just a little bit, I think this is a great palette. And if you love a neutrals, I highly recommend this. The last three palettes I have for you are a little bit more colorful. I do have another one of these Petaphors from Viseart. This one here is the Peridot. Okay. Obviously, love green eyeshadow, and this right here is such a beautiful palette. You get one matte, and these three shades here, I wasn't really sure how they'd go together because this one looks a little bit more emerald, this one a little bit more chartreuse, and this one looks kind of like almost like a deep khaki. I wasn't really sure. But this makes the most beautiful eye look. So if you're looking for something that is a little bit more colorful while still being not too much, and you can get these to really build up, but I like wearing this when it's slightly subdued. I really, really love this eyeshadow palette, and this is one that I have enjoyed so much since I got it last fall and continue to reach for regularly. If you tend to like more plums and berry tones, one of my favorites is this. This is the Tourmaline palette from Wayne Goss. Look at these shades. Look how beautiful they are. I like that we have, some warmth. I like that we have the Celestial shade. Is absolutely stunning. And it tends to have kind of like that glassy, wet type look that just goes right over the top of everything. It's not too much. The one thing that I love so much about Wayne's eyeshadow formula is that it looks really good on my nearly 48-year-old eyelids. The older I get, the more, sagging I have here, the more texture I have on my lids. And sometimes a metallic shade can just look unfortunate. And these, as you can see, they're very soft. They have a nice subtlety to them. They bring light and dimension to the eye. And this Celestial shade, when you press it over the top, it's absolutely stunning. But I love that the mattes don't make my skin look dry. I like that the metallics don't bring out the texture on my lids. It wears really beautiful all day long. And if you like kind of more of a warmer berry, cranberry situation, you would really like Tourmaline. All right, this last eyeshadow palette, I know it came out this summer, but it has really been giving me all the fall vibes. And it's this. It's the Anastasia Nouveau palette. Now, I know a lot of times you'll look at this and be like, but what about that lavender shade in there? Okay, so what I do is I look at it visually like this. And being that I'm fair, I love that we have like these lighter shades over here. This shade here is fabulous. But then there's enough depth right across the bottom that I really do like this eyeshadow palette. One of my favorite shades is this one right here. It's this kind of olivey matte green called Liberty. I like pairing it with this shade right here for a two shadow look. On days that I need a little bit more, I will pull in a shade like this to go along with it. I mean, you can do so much with this. Now, I know there are probably people who love this shade in Wisteria. I'm really happy to just kind of skip right over it. First of all, it's not in my comfort zone. I don't really know what to do with it. And I don't always build looks beautifully together when I feel like there's like, but what do I do with this? I feel like everything else works really well. The other thing about this shade is that it's one of the pigment shades in here. So you could potentially get some irritation or some staining using this shade. So I just kind of eschew the shade in general, love the rest of the palette. And for me, I think that this is really, really beautiful. I like that there is warmth in here with these two shades. I like that I have some green and some brown and some kind of goldy shades. This is like perfect, like everything my heart wants. And because these shades are just a little bit on the lighter side, they're so perfect for my fair skin for all year round, but it has been a heavy hitter this fall. I know they have a new palette out. What is it called? I don't recall what it is. And I really wanted to get it, but I was like, you know, some of those colors are deep enough that I probably wouldn't wear them as much as I have been wearing this. So I'm skipping the new Anastasia palette, but I would love to know what sort of color stories, what sort of formulas, what sort of eyeshadows are you looking for during this time of year? Are there things that are like, when the weather gets cooler, this is what I reach for? Let me know in the comment section down below. Thank you so much for watching today. Have an incredible day, and I will see you again soon.